माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई वांट टू रिवाइज द प्रॉब्लम ऑफ डेफिनेट इंटीग्रेशंस व्हिच आर बेस्ड ऑन द प्रॉपर्टीज। आई वांट टू डिस्कस ओनली वन प्रॉपर्टी टुडे एंड इट्स प्रूफ्स आल्सो। जीरो टू ए एफ एक्स डी एक्स इज इक्वल टू जीरो टू ए एफ ए माइनस एक्स डी एक्स। दिस प्रॉपर्टी इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एंड देर आर सो मेनी प्रॉब्लम्स इन द बुक ऑफ एनसीईआरटी व्हिच आर बेस्ड ऑन द प्रॉपर्टी and which answer will be pi by 4. So it is very, very important for the purpose of MCQ questions also. So now suppose 0 to pi by 2 sine to the power n sine x to the power n divided by sine x to the power n plus cos x to the power n dx is equal to pi by 4. 0 to pi by 2, if n is equal to 3 by 2, then it is sine to the power 3 by 2 x dx sin to the power 3 by 2 x dx plus cos to the power 3 by 2 x dx is equal to pi by 4. 0 to pi by 2 cos to the power 5 x divided by sin to the power 5 x plus cos to the power 5 x dx is equal to pi by 4. 0 to pi by 2 root x plus root a minus x dx is equal to pi by 4. 0 to 1 x 1 minus x to the power n dx is equal to 1 by n plus 1 into n plus 2. 0 to 2x root 2 minus x dx is equal to 16 root 2 by 15. So that 0 to a fx gx dx is equal to twice times 0 to a fx dx. If f and g are defined as fx is equal to f a minus x and gx plus g a minus x is equal to 4. The value of minus pi by 2 to pi by 2 x cube x cos x plus 10 to the power 5 x plus 1 dx is 0 to pi 1. The value of 0 to pi by 2 log of 4 plus 3 sin x divided by 4 plus 3 cos x dx is 2 3 by 4 0 minus 2. Now I want to prove this property. This property is also very, very important for the purpose of examination. So, my dear students, you must derive this result, must solve this property as a problem, and because it will be beneficial for you, and you would be able to solve the problem based on this result, as well as if this problem will be asked independently, you would be able to solve this in the examination. So, my dear student, let I is equal to 0 to a f a minus x dx. A minus x is equal to t. So, dx is equal to minus dt. If x is equal to 0, then t is equal to a. If x is equal to a, then t is equal to 0. So now 0 to a f a minus x dx is equal to minus 0 to a f t dt is equal to 0 to a f t dt. And we know the properties 0 to a f x dx is equal to 0 to a f z dz. So from this property, it is 0 to a f x dx. So my dear students, hence 0 to a f a minus x is equal to 0 to a f x dx proved. This property is very, very important. We can solve so many problems of MCQ types. Now, I want to start the solution of problem. How will you solve? Problem number 1 to 4 are similar problem. And all the problems are based on this problem 0 to pi by 2 sine of angle n to sine of angle x to the power n plus sine of angle x to the power n plus cos of angle x to the power n dx. After applying property 0 to a fx dx is equal to 0 to a f a minus x dx, we have 0 to a sine pi by 2 minus x to the power n sine pi by 2 minus x to the power n plus cos pi by 2 minus x to the power n dx. So it will be cos to the power nx, cos to the power nx plus sine to the power nx dx second. Adding first and second, we have 2i is equal to 0 to pi by 2 sine to the power nx plus cos to the power nx divided by sine to the power nx plus cos to the power nx dx. So 2i is equal to 0 to pi by 2 dx. So 2i is equal to 0 to pi by 2x. So 2i is equal to pi by 2. I is equal to pi by 4. So my dear student, now I want to discuss problem number 5. 0 to 1 x 1 minus x to the power n dx. So you keep in your mind, you subtract x from the variable, from the upper limit. So 0 to 1 x 1 minus x to the power n dx. Now apply this property. We have 1 minus x, 1 minus 1 minus x to the power n dx. Generally, students get confused at this step. They subtract 1 from x. No, we will subtract 1 minus 1 minus x. 1 minus 1 minus x mein ghatana hai 1. 1 minus x whole to the power n. So it will be 1 minus x, x to the power n dx. It will be 1 minus x, x to the power n dx. And after simplifying, it will be 0 to 1 x to the power n dx minus 0 to 1 x to the power n plus 1 dx. And after simplifying, we have 1 by n plus 1 minus 1 by n plus 2. And after solving, we have 1 by n plus 1 into n plus 2. It is very, very important for the purpose of examination because it is general formula. General form x into 1 minus x to the power n. So it is a general problem. So now, putting the value of n is equal to 2, 3, 4, we can also solve this problem. So this problem is very, very important for the multiple type of question. You must solve it frequently. 0 to 2, x root 2 minus x dx. Let I is equal to 0 to 2, x root 2 minus x dx. Applying property first, we have 0 to 2, 2 minus x, square root 2 minus 2 minus x dx. 2 minus x root x dx. 2 minus x root x dx. And multiplying it, we have root 2 dx minus x root x dx. It will be x to the power half dx, x to the power 3 by 2 dx. And now, 2 times x to the power half plus 1 by half plus 1, 0 to 2, minus x to the power 3 by 2 plus 1 by 3 by 2 plus 1. And after solving, we have 2 into 2 to the power 3 by 2 divided by 3 by 2 minus 2 to the power 5 by 2 by 5 by 2. And it will be 4 by 3 into 2 to the power 3 by 2 minus 2 by 5, 2 to the power 5 by 2. So my dear student, after solving, we will get the result 16 root 2 by 15. So you can do this simplification. Now this problem is a general problem, so I want to solve it. This problem is from the book of NCRT. So that 0 to a fx into gx dx is equal to twice 0 to a fx dx. If fn g defined as fx is equal to fa minus x and gx plus ga minus x is equal to 4. So my dear, this is the condition. This is the condition. Fx is equal to f minus x and gx plus ga minus x is equal to 4. There are the two conditions. So, applying these two conditions, you have to prove this result. So, let first you write the problem. 0 to a fx gx dx. This is equation first. I is equal to 0 to f a minus x ga minus x dx. So, I is equal to 0 to a fx 4 minus gx. 4 minus gx. Instead of ga minus x, you write 4 minus gx dx. On adding equation first and second, we get 2i is equal to 4 times 0 to a fx dx. I is equal to 2 times of 0 to a fx dx. My dear students, we want to prove problem number 8. The value of minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. X cube plus x cos x plus 10 to the power 5x plus 1 within the bracket dx each. There are 4 options. This is a combination of so many problems of odd and even function. That's why I selected this problem for revision. And it is very, very important for the purpose of examination. because this is a combination of so many odd and even problems. Now, minus pi by 2 to pi by 2, x cube, x cos x, 10 to the power 5x plus 1, within the bracket dx. Now we split it. There are how many integrals here? 1, 2, 3, 4. So minus pi by 2 to pi by 2 x cube dx plus minus pi by 2 to pi by 2 x cos dx. Minus pi by 2 to pi by 2 10 to the power 5 x dx. Minus pi by 2 to pi by 2 1 into dx. We know that minus a to a fx dx is equal to 2 times 0 to a fx dx if fx is even. And minus a to a fx dx is equal to 0 if fx is odd. So now I is equal to 0 plus 0 plus 0 plus 2 0 to pi by 2 dx. X cube, x cos x and 10 to the power 5x are odd functions. So I is equal to 2 times of x 0 to pi by 2. That is I is equal to 2 pi by 2 is equal to pi. Hence the option C is correct. My dear student, I want to discuss problem number 7. The value of 0 to pi by 2 log of 4 plus 3 sin x by 4 plus 3 cos x dx. And there are 4 options. Let I is equal to 0 to pi by 2 log 4 plus 3 sin x divided by 4 plus 3 cos x dx. Now I is equal to 0 to pi by 2 after applying the properties. You must write after 0 to a fx dx is equal to 0 to a fa minus x dx. This is property. We apply this property. So, after applying this property, we have 0 to pi by 2 log 4, 3 sin pi by 2 minus x, 4 plus 3 cos pi by 2 minus x. And it will be 0 to pi by 2 log 4 plus 3 cos x plus 4 plus 3 sin x dx. This is second. So, adding equation first and second, we get 2i 0 to pi by 2 log 4 plus 3 sin x divided by 4 plus 3 cos x plus log 4 plus 3 cos x plus 4 plus 3 sin x dx. And nothing. This is the 2i is equal to 0 to pi by 2 log m into n. This is on the property log of m plus n is equal to log of m into n. And therefore we have 0 to pi by 2 log 1 dx. We know that log of 1 is equal to 0. Since log of 1 is equal to 0. So here 2i is equal to 0 to pi by 2 0 dx. That is I is equal to 0. Hence the option C is correct. Option C is correct. So in this way, my dear student, we have solved some problems which are based on the single property 0 to pi by 2. Fa minus fx is equal to 0 to pi by 2 fa minus x. And one is very, very important problem. This is based on even an odd function. We have written this result. Minus a to a fx dx is equal to 2 times 0 to a fx dx if fx is even and 0 if fx is odd. We will discuss the proof of this property in next video. I hope these videos are very, very beneficial for you for the preparation of examination. Thank you. Thank you very much.